In this tutorial, I'll show you how to model the spacecraft mesh and create a low polygon rocket exhaust. Here is the rocket animation. I'll put everything into a new collection by selecting and typing M. I'll hide them for now. The spacecraft was based on this design. I'll share the image link in the description below. Shift A and choose image reference to add a reference image. After that, I've adjusted the opacity. A UV sphere was used to create the top part. S to scale. G and Z to move on the Z axis. Control 3 to subdivide. Right click and shade smooth to smooth the surface. The lower part was created with a cylinder. Shift Z to wireframe view. Tab to go to edit mode. 3 to face select. Select the bottom face, and G and Z to move it upward. S to scale. After that, type E, enter, and S to extrude, settle, and scale. Type E once again to extrude downward. E to extrude, and S to scale. Type I as in India to extrude inward, and E to extrude upward. Let's work on the decorative meshes by duplicating the sphere by pressing Shift D. In the side viewport, let's move the smaller sphere mesh on the Y axis like this. I'll add shiny materials for both. For the body mesh, let's right-click to shade smooth. After that, let's auto-smooth the mesh. Let's create an empty object and use that as the smaller sphere's array anchor. Please match my array modifier settings. The sphere was moved upward, so the array isn't working well. Control A to reset all transforms. Let's rotate the empty object on the Z axis like this, and increase the array count. For the second decorative mesh, I'll use a subdivided cube. Control 3 to subdivide. Right-click and shade smooth to smooth the surface. Mouse wheel up will add more loop cuts. Click once and settle, and S and X to scale. I'll use the same orange material. This time let's add 9 array objects in total. We can rotate the second set of the array meshes by applying the modifiers, and tying R and Z to rotate them on the Z axis. Lastly, I'll add a metallic material. I'll show you how I have created the low polygon rocket exhaust. This mesh is using the wave and the displace modifiers together. Let's create a UV sphere. In edit mode, we can select and remove the top half faces. S and Z to scale on the Z axis. We can shape the exhaust mesh by adjusting the settings. The secret is to use a texture and applying them to both modifiers. I'll show you my final settings. Lastly, I'll show you the rocket exhaust shader. Here are the full nodes. By the way, I'm using the Eevee renderer with the bloom setting turned on. The rocket exhaust's color arrangement can be modified easily as well. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.